I believe this would be the most important video you would ever need to watch if you are someone who is in the blockchain industry and using MetaMask. Unfortunately, many people still don't know how to follow the simplest safety procedures when using MetaMask, even though there are certain steps which help you save money. Some had their funds stolen in one go, while others haven't really noticed until the moment they discovered that the money have been leaving their account little by little. If you are someone who thinks, "Oh, this will never happen to me," don't be naive. There is always a possibility for scammers and hackers to get your money, which is why you should be prepared. Trust me, those people who lost their capital are not only average investors. No, they include blockchain industry representatives, those who are coders themselves and people who have built blockchain-related companies. You would think they, as professionals, should be safe. However, if they had their money stolen, think about an average investor. You maybe read the news about one founder of an NFT game who lost 16 CryptoPunks and a bunch of Ethereum after a phishing attack. A scammer created a phishing server which offered NFT investors a chance to win 10 of the elusive NFT avatars in honor of the project's 4-year anniversary. The link directed to the website called lavalabs.io, a very convincing copy of lavalabs.com, the project's actual website that's related to CryptoPunks. The fake website had a pop-up which looked like a MetaMask one. This pop-up said that MetaMask's wallet security has been compromised and you need to provide a seed phrase to restore access. At that time, this person was really exhausted and actually typed in his seed phrase. By doing so, he provided a wallet recovery option to a scammer. We will not dive into more details, but this is just one out of thousands of cases, which is why it's crucial for you to know all common scams. Hi, this is your BunnyMoney channel, everything about crypto, blockchain and trading. I'm your host Vlad. In this episode, we will talk about some sneaky ways that bad actors use to get your money. They are so sneaky, in fact, that unless you are aware of them, you might easily lose your funds. We will also discuss how to protect your wallet. Basically, we can divide the most common types of scams in which people lose money into the following categories: giving an unnecessary access to the MetaMask wallet, using the phishing sites and giving an access to your MetaMask, losing the recovery phrase. The first way of how you can lose money is to give a backdoor access to a specific token to your MetaMask wallet. When using a dApp or a decentralized exchange, you usually are required to use MetaMask to give the website permission to use your crypto assets. When you approve a smart contract, you give permission to use tokens in your wallet. These permissions eliminate the need to approve every transaction when you swap tokens on DEXs or playing a dApp game, but they have their own risks. Currently, there are many smart contracts or projects that have backdoors or loopholes which some nasty people can exploit and use to their advantage. There is a common permission scam which you can find on some malicious websites. This type of permission is called spend an unlimited number of your tokens, which basically means you are giving access to your wallet's specific token to let other people to use your token at any time with an unlimited amount. So it is very important to firstly use big familiar platforms which have been audited by legit auditors or companies and try to avoid new and unaudited platforms. If you give the access to spend an unlimited number of your tokens to a specific token, hackers or people behind this scam would be able to control your funds at any time until you close this permission. Remember, if your money is gone from your MetaMask, it is gone. You cannot recover it, you cannot revoke a transaction, no one can recover it for you, and you will not be able to do anything. Once someone stole the money, they will probably start sending it to different exchanges or different accounts, and it will happen very quickly. It would be really difficult to report a scam and contact different exchanges and ask them to freeze the attacker's funds. An example of a common scam is shown on the screen. As you can see, sometimes when you approve a transaction, there can be multiple transactions inside it, and the one with an unlimited token permission would be hidden for sure. So make it a habit. Every time when you press on your MetaMask to sign in a contract or a transaction, try to read carefully all that's shown to you. You can always revoke the permissions to your MetaMask on special websites. Here, you would be able to check all accesses which your wallet has. In this list, you would be able to revoke the access by pressing on a revoke button. When you do so, you will need to pay a gas fee. For example, BSC scan enables you to check and revoke access to your wallet on Binance Smart Chain. To go there, just open bscscan.com, go to More menu, Tools, Token Approvals, and type in your MetaMask wallet's address. Polygon Scan is the scan website where you can check and revoke access to your wallet on Polygon network. To go there, head to polygonscan.com, choose MISC Token Approvals. Of course, there are some updates and patches which MetaMask is currently implementing to improve security, but you should always rely on as many ways to stay safe as possible. Another thing which is important is a connection with websites which you sign in while using them. To check connected websites in your wallet, just press on the three-dot button, Connected Sites, and here you would see all the websites which are connected to your MetaMask. So if you see any unnecessary websites which look suspicious and which you might connect it to in the past, choose the site you would like to disconnect from, press small remove button, press disconnect button, and now you would see that this website is no longer shown in the connected websites list. Let's actually talk about this access to the MetaMask wallet. It can be exploited by hackers to collect sensitive information and manipulate you in some cases. Let's imagine that someone gets to work on their crypto portfolio in the evening after a long day when they are tired and exhausted. They browse the internet, opening various sites. There is a hacker too who collects sensitive data and, for example, knows that this person uses a browser with an unlocked MetaMask. The hacker sends a fake pop-up right in the top right corner of the website. This pop-up might look very similar to MetaMask, maybe even the same, because this person is very tired or maybe don't do their due diligence. They might use this pop-up and provide their password, approve a transaction, or even type in their MetaMask seed phrase. There is plenty of those who were scammed this way. And another type of scams is when people either lose their seed phrase or share it with scammers. Some still do not understand or underestimate the importance of the MetaMask seed phrase. Seed phrase is the only way to recover or own your wallet, so you should never share it with anyone. Remember, never, never, ever, ever give it to anyone or type it in the places your seed phrase is not needed. For the custodial wallets which are on the centralized exchanges, you always have a double or triple type of verification that you have to go through until you can transfer your funds. There is no double verification on MetaMask. If someone knows your password, they can open settings and find out your seed phrase, which is why don't rely on the password too much. Hackers and scammers live for your lack of attention to details and exhaustion. They exploit the loopholes in the code's architecture and your mind. Scams have become more sophisticated than before, but if you know the basics about your MetaMask, you would know how to protect your wallet. If you are unsure how to use MetaMask or you have just started your blockchain journey, you can watch our MetaMask video where we explain how to use MetaMask in detail. Alright, next I will give you a top 17 security habits which you should adopt when using MetaMask. They are MetaMask installation file. First of all, when you download MetaMask wallet, make sure that you went to the official MetaMask website and downloaded an official MetaMask extension. There is always a possibility that you can get onto the phishing website, which would look almost identical. Phishing websites. Same thing goes for any of the platforms you are using to interact with smart contracts. It can be a duplicate website which looks like an original one with one tiny difference in the domain name. Maybe one letter in the domain can be different. And of course, if you went on this kind of website, do not ever connect your MetaMask and never approve any transactions. If you did it and notice it, quickly go to the scan site and revoke the permission and remove access to your wallet. Do not store the entire portfolio in one wallet, especially one MetaMask wallet. As the famous saying goes, store your eggs in different baskets. If you regularly use different dApps or interact with other platforms using your MetaMask, I suggest you open another MetaMask account just for partly storing your portfolio. This wallet should be used only for storing and never should be used to connect to any of the third-party platforms. Do not use shared computer. Never use your MetaMask on a shared computer. Third-party desktop control tools. Try not to use third-party desktop control tools which can access your computer at any time. Check your browser extensions. There are so many people who like to use different extensions for various purposes. Unfortunately, there are some which can record your screen movements or even read other data from your computer. So try to minimize those extensions and use only those from familiar sources. Do not use third-party black box scripts. While some scripts might help you to automatically play dApp games or do other work and save your time and maximize your profits, others might have a backdoor and access and withdraw your funds from MetaMask. If you really want to use scripts, you should only use open source stuff, which actually requires some coding knowledge to understand. Lock MetaMask. Lock MetaMask wallet anytime you are not using it. If you don't want to do it manually, you can set up auto-locking feature by going to the settings, advanced, auto-locking timer, and set up an auto-lock in minutes, and press save button. If you do so, your MetaMask will be automatically locked within a certain amount of time. If you are not playing any dApp game, I would suggest to set up auto-lock for 30 seconds. When your MetaMask is unlocked, it is possible that the data on your MetaMask can be viewed by other software or hackers. Turn off every experimental feature in MetaMask. Turn on incoming transactions by going to Settings, Security and Privacy. Turn on Show Incoming Transactions. Turn on Use Phishing Detection in Settings, Security and Privacy. Use phishing detection. It will show you warnings for phishing domains targeting Ethereum users. Turn on all the alerts in settings, alerts. Turn on all alerts. Turn off participate in Metametrics. Go to settings, security and privacy. Turn off participate in Metametrics. Try to regularly clear your browser's history and cookies. If you are storing a huge amount of crypto on MetaMask, consider getting a hardware wallet from a legit source. Hardware wallets tend to be the safest way to store your crypto. Try to never download any illegal software or content like music, movies, etc., as they always have a high risk of being infected with Trojan files which can track the data from your computer, and it is illegal. Don't click on links and attachments in your emails if they come from suspicious sources. There are tons of websites which are scam alert tools. Make a habit of checking the platform on a couple of these websites before using any blockchain platform. Your portfolio's security should be your first priority. As long as you secure your wallet and your private keys, your crypto portfolio will be safe. Safety comes with time and effort, and do not underestimate these precautions. You might think that these security measures are not that important, but I would tell you that they really deserve your time and attention. Because there were people around the world who one day woke up, opened their MetaMask and saw a horrible picture, their money was gone. It is a very devastating situation, so please do yourself a favor. Protect yourself and make it difficult for scammers to get access to your wallet. Many people think that MetaMask or a crypto wallet actually stores crypto, but this is a misconception. Crypto wallets only store and display information about your cryptocurrency. Cryptocurrency is stored on ledgers or, as most people understand it, blockchain databases. So if you would like to know more about this whole blockchain world, please make sure you subscribe to our BunnyMoney channel for more educational knowledge. This was our episode for today. Here is your BunnyMoney channel. I'm Vlad. Keep your crypto safe.